Hello friends, myself Amrish from Youplets, your trainer, coach and mentor for the digital marketing. And today I am going to start a very new but very important topic that plays a very important role in the digital marketing course. Before proceeding, you have to know the some points, some meaning and some words that will be used by your entire training and entire digital marketing career. So these are actually the terminology that we use for the digital marketing, starting with some very important thing like keyword or key phrase or key term. What are they actually? This term will be used on a very huge amount in your entire digital marketing career. Whenever a client talk to you, he or she or they will ask you about the keyword, key term and key phrases. So I hope you all know what is the key term, key phrase or keyword. So if you not know, I am just giving you a small glimpse that what is the key term and key phrase. For example, when we open a search engine, we write here like video, cool photos, new song, old song, HD wallpaper. These all are key term or key phrase. If I talk about the single word, love, old, cool, photos, song, new, these are called actually keyword, because the combination of one or two keywords become the key phrase or key term. So this is the very important for your entire digital marketing career. Next thing is search engine result pages, like SERP. Let's start here, write a keyword like digital marketing course. So when I search digital marketing course, this is my key phrase and this is actually the key SERP, search engine result page, where we can see each and everything here. And now what is the cache and index? You can see here a small icon is here. You click on this, then you see this is the cached. This is the cached. Means when you upload a website over the server, search engine initially index that yes, this site is available on the Google, this and it is indexed by the search engine, and once it get a proper place in the database, then it become the cached. Now this is the cached. So you can see here, this is the cached. So this is the cached version of any website that you can see here, source and etc. Now the one more thing is here, I want to explain you what is the backlinks or links. Now let's copy this link here and just put here with this, and then you see a lot of website has linked with this. Now these are the same, but after some time you find third party sites where this particular URL get a backlink. Now I think this is not associated with, so we just take this one only. And now we see that LinkedIn, Play, Amazon. Now this is the here we come. Now first one thing here, Udemy's link is placed on this WordPress blog, then this is called the link for Udemy. And when we check where is our link, then we find somewhere that it is here. So that actually called the backlinks. So link and backlinks is actually the same thing. Link and backlinks is the same to same for a particular website. Either you link it somewhere or you can treat a backlink from there. Now site, website, web portal, e-commerce, these all are you known as a simple website, like this Udemy is a web portal, Amazon is the e-commerce website, and you can see LinkedIn is a social media site. These are all the differentiations of the website that we will optimize in our future. One more very important thing you will hear in your career, that what is the domain and what is the website. Now if you search any keyword on a hosting or domain provider company, then it is the domain only. Like Udemy is a domain if there is nothing on this. Means if it is a park domain, then it is called domain. Let me explain. Now pit stop nutritions is actually a domain. It is only booked, but there is no any website. It is single domain that books from the GoDaddy, and now it is open for the sale. You can sell it, you can purchase it. The owner can sell it and buyer can purchase it. Now this is a website, Hot Services. This is a website that having domain name as well as entire site. This is actually a website. So this is the simple difference between the website and domain. This alt tag, title tag, meta tag, header tag, canonical, breadcrumb, content, duplicate content. These all will be really, really play a very important role. Alt tag and title tag is basically placed on the images, because as per the analyst, they says that search engine is really not able to understand the content over the image. Actually, this is a talk of around 7 to 8 years back, but now search engine having the capability to read and identify about the image. So this is actually the worthless, but still alt tag and title tag plays a very important role in the SEO or optimization, because whatever we place in the, under that alt and title tag is comes as a keyword. So the keyword density will be increased with the help of these tags. Meta tag and header tags, let me explain this. Now I am on this website, and if I go to the source code here, you see a few words are in under title, meta name. These the content under these title, meta description and meta keyword is called actually meta tag, and if we search here h1, so the content inside the h1 tag or h2 tag is called the header tag, because h1, h2, h3, h4, even till the h10 are the header tag. And really these are the very important in the search engine optimization, because the crawler of search engine, the word crawler is a very important that I will explain in a next a few minutes. So the crawler is actually a software that read the entire website, that read the content of a web page, and on the basis of terms, on the basis of key terms, and on the basis of content, that crawler actually decide that this page is which about, means what is the meaning of this page and for which purpose this page has to be made. So the key term or the terms we place inside the header tag and meta tag really play a very important role. So we cannot neglect the presence of h1 tag, h2 tag and other header tags and meta tags. Here one more thing I can explain here, that this content, this is called content. Whatever we are able to see is called content. It is visible to everyone. Every user can read it, understand it. And what is the duplicate content? Duplicate content is this. Suppose I have a website and my competitor start stealing the key content from my website and place on their own website, because he think that if with the same content my site is ranking well over the search engine, then his, why not his? But Google or any other search engine is considered it a duplicate content and will not provide the ranking. One more term is here, canonical. Canonical is a very important term that is actually used for the e-commerce kind website. Website like, so now there are two more terms has to be explained here. One is the canonical and breadcrumb. These actually both terms are very important in the e-commerce website, because in the e-commerce website people are start one thing, one and reach at the end place, but he don't know actually dear from where he or she came. Canonical is used for the search engine purpose, means the website owner explained to search engine that the original page is this. Let me explain with the help of amazon.co.uk. This is a world's very famous website, amazon.co.uk, and here you can see that I am at this page, but here biography, social and health issues and cultural history. So now this book comes under the cultural history, but कल्चरल हिस्ट्री इज कमिंग अंडर द सोशल एंड हेल्थ इश्यूज, एंड सोशल एंड हेल्थ इश्यूज कम्स अंडर द बायोग्राफी. सो दिस इज द थिंग्स दैट यू आर सीइंग हियर इज कॉल्ड एक्चुअली द ब्रीड क्रम. एंड दिस इज एक्चुअली वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टू नो, बिकॉज इफ यू आर नॉट सेटिस्फाइड बाई दिस देन यू कैन अंडरस्टैंड दैट दिस बुक्स कम्स अंडर दिस कल्चरल हिस्ट्री, यू कैन मूव हियर. एंड इफ यू आर नॉट सेटिस्फाइड विद द कंटेंट और थिंग्स दैट कम्स हियर, यू कैन मूव टू अगेन. So this is actually the breadcrumb. So I hope this is clear to you. Now second thing is this canonical issue. Canonical issue. Canonical is an issue as well as help the search engine. Canonical means the things is remain same but ups and down. Means the content above the fold go to the below the fold. I am just going to explain you the fold means. Now you are seeing this with page and this is the above the fold, but as you scroll this, the below content is called the below the fold because this is the actually flow line. So now canonical is what you can see the URL, it is amazon.co.uk/gp/browse/html/node69, but after that there is a very long thing. Now if you sort it on the both books, then you can see that something is changed. So just a moment, you can click on this and you find that something is changed. It's changed, but now I move to the source code, and in the source code I am going to explain you what is actually canonical issue. Yeah, this is the canonical is this. The final URL is already given here, children books, this is the node. Because whatever you are make changes in a website with the help of sorting, searching and your convenience as per the dollar, pound, etc. These all the things is make the change page here, but things remain the same. The things is here can be go upside and the upside thing can be go below side. So just to explain the search engine that this page is changed only for the user, but the primary page is that one. So whenever you decide for the ranking purpose, which page has to be ranked with the keyword, then you select that one only instead of this all the other stuff. So this is actually the first page that I want to explain you, the keyword, key term, SERP, search engine, result pages, check, cache, index, link, but these are really very important for everyone those want to make career in the digital marketing. Now there are some more very interesting terminology that I am just going to explain. Actually these terminology is associated with the Google Analytics and Webmaster, and I will explain this entire thing when I explain about the Analytics and Webmaster. So here just give you a small glimpse, because before that so many times this term can be come in my mind and I can say to you. So session, user page view, bounce rate, landing page, exit page, source, medium, query lead, goal, average session duration, impression and click sitemap, these are very big things. So now here just session means session and user. First we understand the user as myself, user. I came in a 7 a.m. and after that I come 9 p.m. So the single user come with the two sessions, but in the 7 a.m. I seen 5 pages and at the 8 a.m. I seen the 9 pages. So the 7 and 9 pages become the 16 pages. So I seen 16 pages as a single user with the two session. Bounce rate is simply the number of users come on a particular page and the number of user skip from that page only. Means if a single page, just before that I come to the landing page and exit page. There are the two kind of the page, one on which a user land, it's called the landing page, and exit means from which page the user escape from the website, it's called the exit page. The bounce rate is play the role in between these two, landing page and exit page. If the landing page is the exit page, then it counts as the bounce rate. Means if the 10 people are come to a particular landing page and the 10 out of 10, 7 people escape from the landing page, then it's called the bounce rate, or the 70%. But exit page is थ्री दोज पेजेस बाई विच द यूजर स्किप द वेबसाइट मीन्स सपोज द पर्सन लैंड ऑन द होम पेज मीन्स इंडेक्स पेज द थिंग इज इंडेक्स पेज और होम पेज इज द प्राइमरी डोमेन पेज दैट इज कम विद द डॉट को डॉट इन डॉट को डॉट यू के डॉट को डॉट ओ आर जी लाइक दिस दिस इज कॉल्ड द प्राइमरी होम पेज इंडेक्स पेज सो बट आफ्टर लैंडिंग ऑन द होम पेज द पर्सन मूव टू द अबाउट अस पेज अबाउट अस टू सर्विसेज पेज सर्विस पेज टू कॉन्टैक्ट पेज एंड आफ्टर फिलिंग द कॉन्टैक्ट फॉर्म द थैंक यू पेज इज केम एंड ही क्लिक ऑन द थैंक यू पेज एंड एंड क्लोज द सेशन देन द एग्जिट पेज इज द थैंक यू पेज सोर्स एंड मीडियम इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट मीन्स माई वेबसाइट इज गेटिंग ट्रैफिक फ्रॉम द फेसबुक गूगल रिफरल ई मेल इज कॉल्ड द मीडियम सोर्स इज ऑर्गेनिक रिफरल पेड इज कॉल्ड द सोर्स एंड मीडियम लीड क्वेरी एंड गोल इफ समवन कम टू माई वेबसाइट एंड यू फिल द क्वेरी फॉर्म इज एंड आई गॉट अ क्वेरी देन इट्स द लीड एंड इफ आई सेट दिस एंटर प्रोसेस इन माई एनालिटिक्स सेक्शन विद द हेल्प ऑफ गोल देन इट इज कॉल्ड द गोल एवरेज सेशन ड्यूरेशन मीन्स ए पर्सन हु केम टू माई वेबसाइट स्टे ऑन माई वेबसाइट फॉर द 30 to 40 to 60 seconds इज कॉल्ड द एवरेज सेशन ड्यूरेशन इम्प्रेशन एंड क्लिक इज द पार्ट ऑफ एक्चुअली द गूगल वेब मास्टर टूल माई पर्टिकुलर वेबसाइट इज रैंक ऑन द वेरियस पेज कीवर्ड्स अ लॉट ऑफ कीवर्ड्स आर एसोसिएटेड विद माई वेबसाइट एंड ऑन गूगल और एनी अदर सर्च इंजन माई पर्टिकुलर वेबसाइट लोड इट्स ऑन सेवरल टाइम बट इट्स लोड ऑन द 8th position, 9th position, 7th position, and even 2nd page also. So, as long as my site is loaded over the search engine, it's called the impression. And if a person is click on my website web URL, then it is called the click. Sitemap is a very wonderful tool for the user as well as search engine also. Before some time, the sitemap is the only page where we define the architecture of the website, means landing page, home page, about us, which pages inside which pages is the sitemap. But for the search engine, that is actually called web sitemap, where we define the entire architecture of a website. XML sitemap is useful for the search engine purpose, means we can submit our search in sitemap in the search engine, and search engine time to time crawl that sitemap only and index all the new pages. Because every day we create a new page and tell to search engine that please come and index it. Now, average CTR and position. This is again the part of webmaster. Average CTR means click-through rate. That is, I explain here, impression and click. Means if my website getting the 10 impression and got 2 clicks, then CTR is the 20%. Position is SERP. That I already told you that my site is ranking on the 3rd position, 4th position, 6th position. Is called actually the position. So this way Google Analytics and Google Webmaster's primary terminology is completed here. Now I am moving to the next part. In your entire career of digital marketing, so many times you will hear that algorithm and algorithm update, Google update, blah blah blah. So algorithm and update are very common in this field. Algorithm is actually that particular program on the basis of that our search engine, yani means Google, is deciding the ranking and other factors, and time to time it improve its search engine results, so it give some updates. There are so many updates in the search engine fields that I will give you entire history of the search engine from the Florida to current one. Redirects 301 and 302. So many times a website owner decided let's change the domain name, but there are the two conditions. One is for the temporary, second is for the lifetime. For the temporary purpose we use the 302 redirect, and for the permanent we use the 301 redirect. What is the difference in this? Difference in this, in the 302 the link juice of a particular website is not transferred, right? In the 301 the link juice is totally redirect to the new domain. What is the link juice? Link juice actually the power of backlinks. capacity of a site to rank is come from the backlink is actually the power with the help of that Google provide the rank. So this is very important for a particular website. Now so many times you see you are going to open a website and find the error 404, 503 and 504. The 404 error is the error when the page is removed. 503 is the error when the connectivity with the server is not possible, or the server is down, or maybe its hosting is down. 504 is very similar to the 503. In this, the access of a particular page is not given by the website owner to everyone. It's called the 504. Crawler or bot. Yeah, this is the term that I used before sometime, crawler or bot. Actually, crawler is a spider. A spider means a crawler that actually visit every site and see what's update you did. And bot is actually the name of that crawler, that Yahoo bot, Google bot, Yelp, Serp. There are a lot of things. Cookies is very common. Cookies is, I hope everyone is know about the cookies. Cookies is a temporary file that made over the server. When you open a site continuously, then there is a temporary file that very usable files are stored in the cookies. So that next time when you open a site, that easily download. Do follow and no follow. Actually, this is for the backlink. So many websites are giving the backlink, but they place the tag no follow. That means if crawler of the search engine came to their website, then that crawler do not follow the links that I place on my website. But now Google, it says I will follow. So no need to worry about this. Heat map is a very important thing, because heat map is give you the visitor behavior over your website, that from which page person come, how he drag the entire mouse and etc. CSS is really very important, because before sometimes so many programmer place all the code over a single page, that's our landing page or SEO page, so that the length of that website become very long, and when a crawler come to our page, it misguided. Because on a particular page, crawler expect meta tag, content and header tag, but due to CSS it's misguided. So with the help of CSS we can call the important files from the other file. LSI is really very important, and that you have to know, because this is actually tell the Google that what is the meaning of the combination of these words, organic and paid promotion, quality score, ROI and RSS. These are the very important. Organic means I already told you that there is nothing written before the SERP. Paid is with the AD. Quality score is actually come under the paid promotion when our ad is with the quality or not. ROI, return on investment, and RSS is really simple syndication. This is the very good term after the XML sitemap. So these all the things I will explain in a particular class, but as of now I just giving you a simple terminology that might be used by me in the next classes. The other very important is schema markup or rich snippet. So many times you see, so many times we see the ranking and rating with the reviews. This is actually schema markup with the help of schema markup, and this is called a rich snippet. So this is a simple code written in the schema markup and placed in our website as per the desired result, that we want reviews, we want rating, whatever we want. Vote, instead the vote is actually the reviews. The source code, I already told you that what is the source code. B2B, web 2.0 and XML. XML is the very good language, but in this the web page is not created, only sitemap is created. And all the website in which you can create account and write from your end is comes under the web 2.0, like it is the WordPress, it is the Blogger, it is the Facebook, whatever it is. B2B and B2C is the two kind of the business, the business to business and business to client. AdWord and AdSense. AdWord is the paid promotion by the Google, it's called the AdWord, and the code given by the AdWord, the paid promotion by the AdWord is of two type. One is the search and second is the display. So the display ad is the second, first form of the AdSense. When I take the AdWord for the display network, then for someone it is the AdSense campaign. The inside the AdWord we made the campaign and ad group. In this we define the CPC, CPA, CTR and CPM. CPC means cost per click, CPM means cost per acquisition, CTR is already I told you that click through rate, and CPM is the cost per impression, means millions of impression. FTP and CPanel will be used for uploading and downloading the website. Google Map, I hope you all are known. On page and off page are the two kind of the promote activities for the search engine promotion. Robots.txt and sitemap and XML is very important. Let me show you both the files, how they looks like. Robot.txt is actually a file that we upload over the server to instruct the search engine's crawler that which section you have to visit and which section you do not need to visit. So that we want to avoid from the search engine, we place the disallow. The same allow, other than this, everyone, every file, every folder is allowed. The second is XML sitemap. XML sitemap is like this. You see this. You cannot understand this without the help of webmaster, as this is mainly made for the webmaster. So these both are very important and mainly for the search engine. So I hope you all had enjoyed this class and training session. This is the terminology really very important for every person who want the best career in digital marketing. I hope you enjoyed my this section and class, and will be again come for you with a new topic. Thank you for joining me. Myself Amrish from UPLETS. Thank you again.